Welcome to Ascending DC channel. We are an AWS certified partner to provide cloud consulting and technical support to clients who are looking for cloud solutions to tackle the challenge in their day-to-day operations. This video is one of the many short videos we are producing. In each of them, we're going to demo and explain one useful AWS practice that can be used to improve the efficiency and accuracy of your work. All these tricks have been proved effective in our client's success. If you are a project manager, DevOps, architect, software engineer, or just looking for useful cloud practice, this video is made for you. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Today, we are going to talk about AWS single sign-on. As we all know, AWS SSO can help manage user access and permission central to your AWS account or cloud application like Jira and GitHub. It could be an alternative solution for a commercial production-ready platform like Okta. When implementing AWS SSO, we could add our own custom application from AWS SSO Dashboard. In this session, I'll let Sean introduce how to integrate AWS SSO to your custom SAML 2.0 application.
Hi, I'm Sean. I'm a software engineer in Ascending. Today, I'm going to be demonstrating how to add a custom application into the single sign-on dashboard. With the single sign-on, we can create user identities directly in the AWS single sign-on. We can also bring them from a standard-based identity provider, such as Okta Universal Directory, Azure AD, or Google. With AWS single sign-on, you get a unified administration experience to define, customize, and assign fine-grained access. In this demo, I'm going to be using the AWS single sign-on as our identity source and integrate single sign-on with our React front-end application with AWS Amplify framework. First, let's create an application in the AWS single sign-on console. So in the single sign-on console, we choose application in the left side and then choose add a new application. And here we choose add a custom SAML 2.0 application. And we can give it a name here. We can call it test app. And then let's move on to the application property setting. And here we input our start URL. And next, we give it application ACS URL. We use an application start URL to start the federation process with the application. Here's a workflow illustrates the application start URL authentication workflow when a user chooses an application in the user's portal. In the first step, the user's browser redirects the authentication request using a value for the application start URL. In the second step, the application sends an HTML post with a SAML request to AWS single sign-on. Finally, AWS single sign-on then sends an HTML post with a SAML response back to the application. Now, let's move on to the application metadata part. We gave it an application ACL URL here. An ACS URL is used to identify where the service provider accepts the SAML assertions. And here we give it SAML audience. Okay, and we click Save Changes. Some applications require custom SAML assertions to pass additional data about your user sign-ins. Here's an example of supported AWS attributes. Our demo application requires user's first name, last name, and email attributes. So we click Add New Attributes Mapping, and we type in the attributes here. And next, we're going to assign users the single sign-on access to our application. So in the list of our application, we choose the application we just created. And in the application details page, we click assign users. And then we click assign users. In the assign users dialog box, we can either enter a user or a group. So to help simplify the administration of access permissions, we recommend that you assign access directly to groups rather than the individual users. With groups, you can grant or deny permissions to groups of users rather than having to apply those permissions to each individual. If a user moves to a different organization, you simply move that user to a different group. The user then automatically receives the permissions that are needed for the new organization. Here, we just assign the group one to our application. Okay, now to test our single sign-on application, we simply go to the single sign-on user portal. We can find the user portal URL here. The last thing is to download the single sign-on SAML metadata from the application configuration page. With that file, our application knows who is the SAML provider. Okay, now we can test our application through the AWS single sign-on portal. We simply go to the single sign-on user portal and sign in with our username and password. And we can see the test app is here. We can just log, we can just click the application icon. And as we can see, we are logging automatically.
Okay, thank you, Sean. If you'd like to watch more video about AWS Cognito and a single sign-on service, please see below description for other video links. And see you later.
Please leave your comments, questions, critiques to us so we know you are watching. Again, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Ascending DC, and stay tuned for our next video. See you next week.